So I'm going to get straight to the point. I have a message for Omargosh, and pretty much I'm reacting to a video that was a live stream that he had made, and it was called I'm Really Scared, Something Is Haunting Me.
We've been having weird shit happening in here from the beginning. I mean, I have a haunted clown here. It's some haunted objects here, but nothing that was like remotely crazy to the point where we're like, you know, oh my God, like this place is, you know, nuts. Like I'm not going to stay there. So there's been a couple nights. I believe it was a few months ago, right around the time that my mom passed away, and I had that dress in the closet. But Tiffany complained about the bed shaking in the middle of the night, which I never felt. And I kind of, you know, I was just like,
it was like a bump.
Oh God, you scared the shit. What was it?
It wasn't like a shake.
I didn't know you were there.
It was like a bump.
It was a bump. Okay.
Yeah, it was like a bump.
Well, I never felt that bump. And supposedly, like, I blamed it on the dog. And Tiffany was like, no, the dog was on top of the bed. So there's no way that it could have been the dog. So what was this bump? I want to say it was like two nights later, I felt that bump. And the same thing, my dog just stayed there and was just like, she was like, she didn't do nothing, okay? And Luna barks at everything, okay? And it wasn't like, actually, it wasn't a bump like what she describes. It felt like somebody kicked the bed, like the bed frame. Like it was a kick. And I felt it. The whole bed shook. Did you feel it that night?
I did. We both woke
up. Oh, we both woke up from that.
And, you know, I'm a new subscriber, so I haven't gone through all of his content. I don't know too much about him. I literally followed him within the last, I don't know, 3 days or so. I don't know. It wasn't even a week, I don't think. But so I'm reacting to his video to give him some clarification and some information, insight that may help him. And some of the struggles he might be dealing with, especially like if he is having a haunting at his clown cottage, maybe he's looking for answers. But anyway, I'm a psychic medium. I see dead people. I see all sorts of shit, whether they're human, non-human. I see elementals. I see a whole ton of things. And so, you know, I wanted to relay this message to him. Hopefully he sees it. If not, I mean, he's got 1.4 million subscribers on one channel and another million on another channel. So, anyway, Mr. Omargosh, I hope you see this video, and I hope, you know, it gives you some insight on what's going on, at least it with yourself and your clown cottage situation. So, while I was watching the video, you know, I was immediately getting psychic impressions, and yeah, I was seeing things really, really, really fast. Now, I am clairsentient and clairvoyant. I have all the clairs, but those two are my strongest, okay? And so, as I started watching your video, about 18 minutes in, right? That's when I started getting the feedback, because that's kind of where you start talking about your haunted situation that you've got going. And so, first impressions here. We know you got haunted items in there, like those clowns. Why does it gotta be clowns, first of all? I'm just kidding. But anyway, you got haunted clowns and dolls and things. But, so you were talking about your wife's experience when she was sleeping and that feeling of something bumping the bed, and then how you also felt it and it felt like something kicked the bed and you were like, is that my mother? No, that specific incident was not due to your mother, okay? So, when I was looking at, or looking in, pretty much, at that scenario, and I'm reading off my notes because I took notes. So I was seeing a human-like entity, and I say human-like because I've learned that many things can shapeshift into things that they want that are not necessarily human, but that doesn't also mean it's a demon either. But I'm just going based off of first impressions. that I was getting. So, human-like female entity with long dark brown hair, almost black, but you could still tell it was dark brown. And it's so long that it goes to her waist, and I just see it floating as she's floating. And she's in this, like, nightgown dress situation, and because of her aura, it's gray. I'm gonna say she's an earthbound spirit because of the aura that surrounded her. Usually when you have things that are really evil or non-human, the aura is darker. And this was like a gray situation, and it made her white nightgown dress situation look gray. But it was, I'm pretty sure it was white. And she was barefoot, hovering over the bed, making weird faces. She's what kicked the bed and what's moving the bed. Why? Because she's trying to evoke a fear response. When you have a fear response, it produces negative energy, and that gives her, you know, a food source. So that's what. So if you're noticing paranormal activity in your space, it's her. But yeah, not your mother. But so I did leave a comment under your video, under this specific video, of the things that I was picking up. So I picked up three things. Well, technically four. You do have a portal in that space. Actually, because you have haunted items, you have multiple portals. But I did see one main big portal. And it looked like your stereotypical, like, swirly one. But it was, like, a dark purple, which means the portal itself is dark. And it's not something you want in your space. If you're having nightmares, sleep paralysis, if you're having headaches from psychic attacks or dizziness, anybody in your family. So this could be, you know, kids, wife, whomever. If they're having nightmares, sleep paralysis, stabby pains in their head, dizziness, it's because of the earthbound spirit chick that's there. And she is not tied to any of the haunted items, I don't think. The haunted items are their own separate issue that we will be talking about. But, so, yeah, there are multiple entities, so the chick over the bed, that's one. The second one is your attachment. Yes, you have an attachment, unfortunately. It is tied to your solar plexus, but because your heart chakra is also imbalanced, it's now working off of that, which your heart chakra is imbalanced right now due to, you know, the loss of family members, which, you know, when you lose family members or any loved ones, having an imbalance of your heart chakra is actually kind of normal. So it's just taking advantage of that, unfortunately. If you're feeling drained, again, there's a whole host of reasons. It's that earthbound spirit, but also the haunted items in your space. The attachment to your solar plexus, I'm pretty sure that's non-human. And guys, non-human doesn't necessarily mean demon. All right, it's not, nothing here is demonic. So don't worry about that. There's no demon issues here. The attachment is more parasitic, okay, if that makes sense. I have a lot of experience with parasitic attachments in entities, and honestly, they're kind of one of the most, I would say, I don't want to say popular, but most common, there we go, the most common entity I see as attachments, and that's because, you know, they feed off of you, your traumas, all the negative emotions or energies that you put out. Unfortunately, that's how they be. But so that's the non-human entity attached to you. Let's see. Did I get it all? Earthbound, non-human attachment, portal. It's a dark purple portal swirly situation. Yes. And then obviously the entity is tied to your haunted items. Oh, so I did connect with your mother. Now, so before I connected, or as I was connecting to her, I was getting chest pains. And, you know, because I'm a new sub, I haven't gone through all your content, so I'm not quite sure how she passed away. But if it has to do with, like, the chest area, whether that's, like, a heart attack or something involving the chest, I think it was a heart attack, but I'm not quite sure, again, because I haven't gone through your content. But clairsentiently, I was getting chest pains. But she wanted me to tell you, and this is another reason I wanted to do this message for you. I don't often get messages from human, like, loved ones, because I focus so much on the paranormal haunting stuff, because I'm trying to help people with that. But this message needs to be said. So, your mother gave me a message to tell you that she loves the little conversations that you have with her when you go visit her, but also, like, when you're at home or on the job or doing your investigations and you're talking to her in your head. She loves that because she knows that you know that, you know, she's around. And that gives her comfort. Now, she was pointing at something that you're going through. You're also having, like, some kind of chest pain, but it's more like a heartburn and a sore throat. And when I get both of those at the same time, it leads me to acid reflux. And she wanted to point out that, you know, acid reflux is sometimes caused by anxiety, but also, like, your specific diet. And she just wants to make sure that, you know, you're taking good care of your health and you're working on, you know, your heartburn and that kind of stuff. She also pointed out that you need to do a better job protecting yourself spiritually when you're on the job, when you're, you know, doing your investigations. She's worried that you're going to bring things back, which you have in the past, and that kind of worries her. And then back to the health. I'm feeling it right now, actually, as I'm talking about it. But as, okay, so for the health part, I keep hearing and seeing you burp a lot. Now, this could have to do with, like, the heartburn and stuff. Or, I don't know if, like, goofing off, you're just burping and having fun. But I see her, like, nagging you and being like, cut it out. Like, do you have to be so gross? Or, like, you have to be so loud. Like, you know, like a mother nagging their kid when they're, you know, making noises and stuff that they don't like. I see her doing that and pointing out how that while she did nag you, she did kind of think it was funny at times. So she just wanted to point that out. Yeah. So things that I would mostly pay attention to, though, with yourself is, like, diet and working on your chakra imbalances. So your solar plexus and your heart chakra, working on past traumas, because that's how the negative entities are feeding off of you, especially your attachment. That negative earthbound spirit, your mom wants out of that. At that space, that clown cottage you're at right now, or at least in the video you were at, she wants that chick gone because she's nasty and she's just making your health issues worse, but also the health issues of people that are staying in that house worse. And yeah, so let's get to the haunted dolls, shall we? The thing with the haunted dolls, I did a interview with Dead Serious Investigations. He collects haunted objects to study them, but also to keep them away from, you know, people so they don't fall into the wrong hands and then it messes with them. And, you know, it's more for protecting other people. Okay, so the thing with haunted objects, you're going to make sure that you are taking care of them in a specific manner and that you're taking care of them, you know, properly. So when you have haunted items, you got to make sure you cleanse them. You got to cleanse your space and yourself. Because if you do not, the entities attached to those objects will affect you negatively. Absolutely. And also, if you don't regularly clear that space, the negative energy, not only from the haunted objects, but the earthbound spirit that's lingering in that space, is just gonna pretty much defile that energy that's there and just make it darker and less comfortable, and yeah, you don't want that. So you need to cleanse those dolls, whether you use sage, palo santo, prayer, holy oil, or holy water. I recommend binding them. You can put them in their own cases if you want, kind of like how the Annabelle doll is. You can do that. You can put salt around them, but I highly recommend researching the proper use of salt, because you can trap things in or trap things out, and you just gotta, you know, be careful with that. I always recommend praying to the archangels or Jesus, and the holy oil and holy water do work. I do use it to cleanse my space too, and especially to seal like the windows and mirrors and things. Highly recommend. So yeah, like I said, and oh, and when you communicate with the haunted objects, by that energy transaction between you and the haunted object, you can create portals that way, which then bring in more things. So you have to be careful, and you gotta make sure you cleanse the portals and close the portals, especially that big one in your space. And it looks like your kitchen is where that big one is. Oh, burps. Yeah, so you gotta close that portal. Oh, and don't forget to cleanse your equipment, your spirit boxes, cameras, everything that you use in your investigations. You gotta clean. You gotta cleanse. And you can do that, again, with sage and palo santo. I mean, for that stuff, that stuff's easier to cleanse. And then to get that spirit chick out of your house, the earthbound spirit, you need to, you know, kick her out. Acknowledge, A, that she's there, and then B, tell her to leave. And then with that intention, you can either burn, you know, your white candles. But my go-to is always the sage and palo santo. You do the sage and then the palo santo. The sage puts the void of energy, kicks shit out. And the palo santo puts the positive energy back in. And when you put the positive energy back in, that makes it harder for the negative stuff to come back to fill it, because then that space is already filled with the positive energy. So you probably already know this because you're a paranormal investigator. But if you don't, ta-da. But so that's very important that you need to focus on. Let me think. I think I nailed everything. Yeah. Those are all the things that I had picked up, and then the messages that your mother wanted to relay to you. Hopefully, again, you see this video. If you don't, guys, please share it. Share it to him so he sees it. You know, the whole goal of my channel is to make sure everyone is safe as they're, you know, experiencing and dabbling into the whole spiritual situation and the paranormal. We just want to make sure everybody's safe. And anything that, you know, kind of intercepts or any negative things trying to get in the way, I'm trying to help you guys get rid of, so, you know, you can live your best life and be happy. That is the goal here. But yeah, if you watched this video through the end, thank you so much. Hope to see y'all soon. Again, thank you guys for watching. Peace out. If you are looking to learn more about haunted objects, I have two videos where you can do just that. The first one is the Dead Serious Investigation collab I did on my channel, and the second one is the interview we did with him on Lights at Midnight podcast, where we go fully in depth into his haunted items and the things that occur with them. But yeah, I highly recommend checking those two videos out.